Thanks. I was about to put it there myself.
So, how are you?
I'm fine. And you?
Good.
When'd you get back?
This morning. I tried to call you twice.
Yeah, I know.
Look, I'm sorry for missing dinner at your place. Please send my apology to Christy and Brad. I didn't mean anything personal by it. I mean, I really had no choice.
Oh, come on, Sam. Look, if I had my choice between a lasagna dinner or grabbing a private jet to New York to hobnob with
the
rich...
That is hardly the way it was. I mean, I barely had time to sit down, and when I did, I fell asleep. That was in the Philharmonic. As a matter of fact, that's where I called you from the second time. Started thinking about that day we went to see the Pink Panther. Look, Kyle, the whole trip happened so fast. I mean, I only found out about it when I was in the limo. I only had the clothes on my back. I didn't even have a toothbrush. Mr. Hale took care of everything.
Well, it must be nice having a boss cater to your every need.
It was business, Kyle.
Look, Sam, you don't owe me an explanation.
Well, then stop making me feel like I do. Look, let's just get out of this place and talk, okay? I'll even buy you lunch.
What did you do, get a raise?
As a matter of fact, I did.
Well, then you really must have performed well in New York.
Sam, aren't you gonna have any?
No.
And you were wrong, Monique. I was?
About Kyle, he doesn't give a damn. He doesn't care either way. I went over to his office, I apologized, and then after he made me feel guilty, he said it doesn't matter anyway. Well, fine. I don't need him.
Sam, he just doesn't want you to know he's jealous, that's all.
Of what, Jordan?
Mm-hmm.
But give me a break. Jordan is my boss, pure and simple.
Well, it may not have appeared so pure after he jetted you off to New York.
Well, then if Kyle's jealous, then why doesn't he say so?
Because guys don't like to admit that kind of thing.
Well, then he better get his ego out of his earring if he wants me around. Maybe he's just smarting because he's not used to being stood up.
Oh, so that's why you did it.
No, it was business, Monique, all right? Look, I'm not going to fall all over him just because he's Lieutenant Kyle Masters, ace homicide cop. I have a career I'm building. There happens to be a man, my boss, who appreciates me and what I do. So if you'll excuse me, I am going back to work.
Have you recovered yet?
Oh, yeah, I'm fine.
Good. Well, I hope your memories of Manhattan were pleasant.
Of course, I just can't believe it all happened so fast.
Well, next time I promise we'll go a little slower, and we will have dinner at the Four Seasons.
Well, I'm not complaining. I mean, that room service feast wasn't so shabby.
Well, you did a wonderful job on the trip, Sam. I'm very pleased with your work.
Thank you. Especially when I think back to my major and minor screw-ups.
Oh, yes. Who will ever forget the famous Edo incident?
I almost severed ties with Japan on that one, didn't I?
Close. But I have to admit, you were a worthwhile project in spite of it all.
Project?
Yes. When I hired you, it was a sort of a test to see if you could cut it.
So... is the verdict in?
You got a raise, didn't you?
I sure did. I don't know what to say, except thank you.
Just keep up the good work.
I will. And I really appreciate it. Mr. Hale, it's a good feeling to know someone has confidence in me.
Well, I do. And I guess it's my turn to thank you.
Me for what?
For giving me a fresh view of Manhattan. Seeing it through your enchanted eyes made it seem new to me.
Is it safe to approach?
Jason, what are you doing here?
Well, you were bummed at lunch, so...
I'm sorry, I was just caught up in another thing.
Yeah, well, listen... how about if we get together and celebrate your raise tonight?
Oh, I'm up for that. What do you want to do?
It's already been set. You're going to join Monique and I at the McCallum Guesthouse for dinner tonight at 8 o'clock No repeaters. Okay?
Sounds good. Let's
okay.
do it.
I'll see you tonight. I gotta get going.
Bye.
Bye, baby.
Good afternoon. This is the
Winston Hotel front desk. Yeah, I know.
Hi, Sam.
Hello?
Listen, I was thinking, and I'm sorry I missed lunch today.
Hey, it's okay. Never want to interfere with your work.
Well, I'm not working tonight. Would you like to join me for dinner?
I can't. I just made plans.
Now, how did I know you were going to say that?
Look, what kind of a crack is that? I mean, why do you always wait to call to the last minute?
Hey, you are hardly the one to talk about last-minute plans. I mean, what is it going to be tonight, Paris?
You know, for someone who's supposed to be so good at solving mysteries, you do not have a clue what you are talking about.
Well, then maybe I should stop. I mean, I don't want to get in your way. You probably got to start packing, right? At least one bag, anyway. Have a good time. Well, if that wasn't the most pathetic, you stupid jerk. Why do you set yourself up for these things? Damn!
Hello?
Link? Hi.
Hi.
Come on in. What's on your mind?
To get right to the point, are you busy tonight?
Well, as of about 1 minute ago, no, I'm not.
Oh, what happened?
Well, I asked Sam out for dinner, but it seems she has other plans.
Oh.
I guess Jordan Hale wins again.
Well, in that case, would you like to join Jason and me for dinner tonight at the guest house? Around 8 o'clock?
Monique, that's very nice of you to ask.
Well, then be nice and accept.
Oh, okay, I do. This would be a perfect way for me to forget everything. And everyone.
Ahead of you, my man.
Thank you, sir. This is one of my eccentricities.
Yes, one of them.
Kyle, there's cheese and crackers on the table. Help yourself. Make something.
Oh, great. I'll do that. Hey, you guys expected someone else?
Sorry I'm late. I brought salt and bread. Housewarming. What is he doing here?
What is she doing here?
Hey, look, we just thought we'd invite our two best friends to dinner and an evening at home with us, that's all.
Honey, can you help me with something in the kitchen?
With what? Oh, that stuff in the kitchen.
What happened? Paris get called off?
I didn't have any plans with Jordan for this evening, if that's what you're referring to. It was Jason's invitation that I had accepted before you made that arrogant phone call expecting me to drop everything again and meet you for dinner.
Arrogant? Me?
I'd say the shoe fits.
All right, maybe I jumped to the wrong conclusions about your friend, Jordan.
Well, in your line of work, that kind of thinking can get you in a lot of trouble.
But as for asking you to drop everything, I'm sorry. I have a tight schedule. I can't plan dinner engagements months in advance like some of your well-heeled friends can.
Look, that is not fair, and you know it.
Okay. This moment calls for toast, Sam. To the future. May it be filled with friendship and peace.
Here's his wedding presents, and I finally learned how to work one of them.
Yay.
I believe it. Okay.
Honey, what'd you use in here? Coffee beans or root tar?
You guys, I'm sorry.
I'm kidding. I'm kidding. Oh. I'm kidding. I'm kidding. Just next time, take a little easy on us, okay?
Yeah. Sorry.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, for the entertainment portion of the evening, you two are lucky enough to be the first ones to view our honeymoon slides.
Wow.
Jason, didn't anyone ever tell you that when you go on a honeymoon, the only thing you're supposed to do is make love?
Well, you see, when you marry a photographer, my dear, you do both.
Kyle, come with me.
I want you to sit right over here, and Sam, you sit right next to Kyle, because it's the best seat in the house to see from.
Baby, can you get the lights for me, please? Thanks. All right. Okay, here we go. This is our version of Tropical Paradise.
Ooh,
Oh, very artistic, Mr. Craig.
Why, thank you.
Oh, that's the Hail Maui.
Hail Maui.
Oh, Jason!
Oh, God. Sorry, hon. It's for private viewing only, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, oh, here we go. Now, this is Kapalua Bay. For my money, this is definitely the prettiest part of the island. Look at that. Oh, okay, now here we are in Kauai, and this spot right here is called Poipu Beach. We took a little side trip over there for a few days. What a spot. I'm telling you, that place has got some of the best boogie boarding and body surfing in the world. Honey, can you give me another box of slides? Thanks. Now, this is back on Maui. This is the Hana Ranch, and it's up in the hills. I gotta admit, this is Monique's favorite place. Every time I took her there, she...
We're gonna go up to the main house to get some brandy for after dinner drinks.
Yeah, we'll be back in a little while.
I'd say they're trying to get us together.
Yeah, and they're not being too subtle about it either. I don't know why Monique did this.
Would you like to finish that dance we started at the Opera Bowl? As I recall, we were very rudely interrupted.
Yeah, I think I'd like that.
Just what do you mean to me? Here in my heart, I believe your love is all I ever need. Holding you close through the night, I need you.
Honeymoon hula down the aisle to the Twilight Zone. That's where I feel I've been all night. Oh, and then when Jason brought out that fourth box.
They knew exactly what they were doing. Nothing scares guests away faster than a slideshow of someone else's honeymoon.
Well, it worked. I gotta tell you, though, that Jason, he's really a brilliant photographer. He made everything look so romantic.
Yeah, he sure did.
I guess they were trying to inspire us. It was a nice thought.
It was a rotten trick, inviting us without the other one knowing.
Well, are you sorry they did it?
No.
Well, I'm glad you're not mad at me anymore.
Don't be so sure about that. I don't know if anyone's ever told you, but you can be pretty insulting sometimes.
I wasn't insulting you. Just your boss.
Kyle, you don't know Jordan, and if you did, you'd realize he was a nice man who believes in my potential.
Let me just make one more comment, and then we can get on to nicer things, okay? Be careful about Mr. Hale taking advantage of your potential. Don't be naive about this guy. He's making a play for you. Otherwise, why would he whisk you off to New York?
Maybe to make you jealous?
Well, he succeeded.
Kyle Masters admits he's jealous.
Now, can we get on to those nicer things?
Look, I'm sorry. I'll just Barricade. Yeah, I'll barricade myself in my room.
No, Adam. Really, I was just leaving.
What?
Yeah, I gotta check in with the station.
At this hour?
Hey, crime never sleeps.
Guess it happens to all of us, huh? Having to run off and work nights.
Yeah, except that my night duty has me working with Lieutenant Nestor.
Well, lucky you.
I had a good time tonight. I'll call you. Take it easy, Adam.
See you later.
Look, don't jump to any conclusions. It was just a little kiss.
Yeah, maybe, but it was a great little kiss. Yes, it was. Uh-huh. Tell me that that guy's not special.
You know, Sam,
do you remember how we used to look at Jason and Monique? I mean, how we'd moan and groan about we'd never have anybody?
You know, you say that with such contentment. Could it be that Maya is finally in your life?
Well, Sam, ever since she started that job at the hotel, I don't know, things have changed. She's got more confidence. I can see it.
Adam, I've got to hand it to you. Getting her that job teaching aerobics worked out in more ways than one. Everyone loves her at the hotel.
Well, yeah, I mean, things worked out for the best, but, I don't know, this gives her a salary, this keeps her involved in her dancing, and she'll probably be able to move out of that rooming house soon.
Yeah, and I'll bet you're encouraging that.
Oh, all the way. I mean, the woman who runs that place is too strict. You know what? And her parents, they were against her moving to Chicago to study dance.
She told you all that?
Well, yeah. Yeah, she finally opened up to me about her personal life, her family, her...
Adam, that should tell you how Maya feels about you.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm so happy for you. I mean, after everything you went through with Doreen and the baby, I knew Maya would come around. I mean, after all, how many guys are there out there like you?
My sentiments, exactly.
Yes, Lieutenant Masters, this is Jessica Donnelly.
Mrs. Donnelly, surprised to hear your voice. What can I do for you?
Well, I was rear-ended by a car tonight, and by the time I got out, the car drove away. But I did manage to get the license plate number. I was hoping you could put it through your police department computer.
That's traffic division. I'm homicide. You weren't killed, were you?
That's very funny. No, you see, you're the only policeman I know, and I was hoping that I could get this done without a hassle.
All right, give me the number. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'll get back to you in a bit.
Thank you, Luke.
Jessica, it's Kyle Masters. I have that information you wanted.
Yeah, hang on a second. I have information on the license plate.
How did you get it?
I'm ready.
The car is registered to Ted Winters.
Ted Winters.
Try to get an address.
Would you have an address on that?
Well, it's registered to a place called Wilson and Friends.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I appreciate that. Thank you.
You planning on filing an accident report?
Absolutely. You see, my car had a lot of damage. Well, thanks again.
One more thing. While I did the car check, I also did a background check on this Winters guy.
A background check? What's his background?
He's clean.
Oh, good. Thank you.
Let me know if you need anything further.
Oh, I'm sure you'll have enough to keep you busy in homicide. Thank you, Lieutenant.
Was that Masters?
Yes, well, I thought since we knew him, it would happen a lot faster.
Are you out of your mind? Do you realize what'll happen if he gets anywhere near this?
Good night, I'm exhausted.
Okay, pleasant dreams.
I plan on it, and I bet you do, too.
I'll get it. Hello.
Hi, Adam.
Maya.
I'm telling you, you guys are blowing it again. Where do you get your information?
Just answer the question, Dewey. I don't need any lift.
You ought to put me in a cell with him.
What are you in here for, honey?
Will you quit leaning on me?
All right, fine. But you just be ready to go back out there when I get my phone call. I hate wasting time.
That's all we've done on this damn case.
Well, from the ridiculous to the sublime.
Now, how did you know you were exactly what I needed?
Rough day?
I swear this case is making me old before my time.
Yeah, I could see that when you walked in.
I guess it's Corelli's sixth sense of humor partnering me up with Nasty.
Well, I mean, you don't always get to work with people you like.
When did you become so wise?
Well, I've always been wise. You've just been too busy to notice. So, what savage murder are you working on now?
This is serious business, Sam.
Whoa, watch out for RoboCop.
No kidding. We're dealing with the mob here, and just knowing about it could put you in jeopardy.
Well, then I guess I'll just have to get you to protect me. Oh, yeah, I got off work early. I was hoping you could do the same. I still haven't seen your place.
Mm-hmm. And whose fault is that?
We gave me another chance.
Kyle, what the hell is going on with you?
Get me off this case.
No, this is top priority. I put you with Nestor for a good reason.
I'm not a babysitter.
Now, you listen to me. This case and this department depend on teamwork. We cannot function without it.
Why are you doing this to me?
I mean it. I don't want to hear any more. You have your orders. Now, you take it from there. Sorry for the interruption, Sam.
We're used to it.
I can count on you, can't I?
I thought Jordan was tough.
Jordan Hale. Now, what about dinner?
It sounds like you've got work to do.
Hey, even a cop's gotta eat.
I don't know. I mean, I don't want to come between you and Nasty.
Come between us, please.
Let's go. Car's waiting.
I don't believe this.
Masters.
My place, later.
What about the case?
Oh, we're gonna get a lock on that tonight, aren't we, good buddy?
Masters, we're tailing the hitman. Who the hell knows what can happen?
Kyle!
We'll be fine. I see you at 8.
Can we get out of here now?
Careful. Place.
Well, it's an old firehouse. Listen, on a cop's salary, you can't be too picky.
Oh, this is fabulous. Oh, gosh. All these games. God, I bet you can really unwind here.
Well, that's the idea.
So, what do you do when things get too hot in your firehouse?
Well, you see, that's for me to know. And you to find out.
Alone at last.
Sounds too good to be true. No.
This is becoming a habit. Hi.
Hope we're not late.
No, right on time. Oh, wait a minute, I thought you were bringing pizza.
So did I brought Chianti.
Oh, Monique just happened to have a craving for Chinese.
Does that mean... No, I just felt like shrimp with oyster sauce.
Right here,
oh,
darling.
Thank you. Now that's long. So, should we just dig in or what? Why not?
That's what we're here for.
Yes.
I'm so glad this stuff is hot. I am starved.
So, Kyle, if you're the big expert on puzzles, I got one for you. Mm-hmm. It's the $60 million question. Now, where do you think an old bag would hide that kind of money?
We talking about Aunt Mary?
Man, she withdrew every dime, and it's nowhere to be found. At least not in this country.
Maybe she deposited in some Swiss bank account.
Do you think maybe you could put an official investigation on it for me?
Sure.
How long do you think it'll take?
Well, it could take a while.
Well, then, do you think you could arrange for me to see Aunt Mary?
Are you kidding?
Baby, she's the only one who knows. Maybe she'll tell me so.
Oh, a couple years. Hey, but Monique, babe, come on, you gotta start thinking big. It's not gonna be too long before you and Jason move into your own mansion.
Oh, I'm in no hurry.
When we do, you guys can drop by for takeout anytime.
Oh, thanks a lot. Oh, you guys, I almost forgot. Can't have Chinese without cookies, fortune cookies.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, babe. Maybe I'm going to inherit $60 million.
Right now, I'd settle for a fortune to tell me where Aunt Mary hid hers. Thanks anyway, but we know when four is a crowd.
Okay, don't be strangers.
And actually, Chinese was nice for a change.
Good. Hey, you're going to set up that meeting with Aunt Mary, right?
Absolutely. First thing tomorrow.
Thanks, buddy.
Night.
Good night.
Thanks, guys.
So, what should we do with the rest of the night? You got any ideas?
Yeah, I think there's a couple extra fortune cookies. Oh, must be fate. One for each of us.
Okay, okay. If you should say, romance will come your way. I like that. Read yours.
Oh, there's no cholesterol in this cookie.
You're kidding. Let me see that. Let me see it. Confucius say, not necessary to open eyes to see. Well, you heard the man. Close your eyes.
Why?
Just shut up and listen to Confucius.
Get your coat, Masters. We've got a meeting to go to. Oh, howdy do. I'm sorry to interrupt.
Yeah. What else is new?
What meeting?
Our informant called. He's ready to talk. Well, let's get our butts in the car. We ain't got all night. Come on.
I'm sorry, Sam. I gotta do this. Look, I don't think we'll be back tonight. You got the wire?
Yep. I'm sorry to take your boy away, but I'll make sure he comes back in one piece.
Look, I hope you understand.
Yeah, just be careful.
So, where are we meeting him?
The warehouse. He wouldn't let us pick the spot, but I figured, you know, may not get another chance.
Okay.
First time you dated a cop, huh?
Listen, just close the door behind you. It locks itself.